What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to Comic Breakdown. If you guys are new to the channel, do me a favor and hit that sub button, hit that notification bell, and make sure you're not missing any of the awesome content we have coming out. Now, for this video, we're going to be diving into Daredevil issue number 33. And if you haven't been keeping up with this line, go ahead and check out the link in my description as well as the top of this video. We have been covering Daredevil since the King in Black event. And so far in this line, we have seen writer Chip Starsky, which for the most part, I love most of his work. We've seen Daredevil be stuck inside of prison for quite some time now. Elektra on the outside, taking up the mantle of Daredevil while he is away. But something happened. Mayor Fisk was trying to manipulate things and trying to create his own assassin, one he could control, and that was in the form of Bullseye. But somehow, some way, there ended up being multiple clones of Bullseye, and Elektra stuck with a knife in her back. And with that being said, let's dive into this breakdown. Alright guys, so as we dive into this issue, we're picking up 4 weeks ago. And 4 weeks ago, Mayor Fisk was telling these scientists that they need to figure out how to make it to where he can control Bullseye, to where he would be completely compliant. Because at the end of the day, Mayor Fisk is looking to have his own private assassin. Not any assassin, his own private, best in the world assassin. And so after the time goes by, they're figuring out they can't just change his mind. They can't make him complacent. And so they get the idea to make clones. They make a couple of clones and they try to clean the slate, make it to where he has no memories, no thoughts. He has only one directive, and that directive is to listen to what Mayor Fisk says. And of course, there's lots of questions. Is this a good idea? Should we be really cloning a psychopath like Bullseye? Will this even work? But at this point, they don't have any other options, and they don't want to infuriate Mayor Fisk any more than he already is. But as they are doing all of this, something happens. One of the Bullseyes start bleeding out, and so they rush over, they open it up, and Bullseye kills the guy instantly, killing him and looking around the room, not knowing where he is, not knowing what the heck is going on. He tells everybody they need to start talking before he starts dropping bodies. And so this gives us the origin to where all of these clones came from, why they are here, and now that Bullseye is able to free all of his clones, we can only imagine the mayhem that they want to enact on the entire city. And that's what's gonna pick us up with present day. And we see the knife being pulled out of the back of Elektra. Now Elektra knows that whoever this individual is, whoever this Bullseye is, they could have killed her, but they chose not to, driving the knife in exactly the right spot, because they want to make this slow. They want to make her suffer. Now, as it stands, Elektra, she is dripping blood right now. She is leaking. But she has two Bullseyes in front of her. Two of them that are in close quarters, which may give her the upper hand. The only concern is there is a third up on the rooftop. A third with a rifle and a silencer. And though she doesn't really understand what is going on, she doesn't know if these are all actually Bullseyes or wannabes, she knows that she is not dying this day, and from her bag, she grabs two smoke bombs, throwing them onto the ground. And with it comes a giant flash as well, giving her the opportunity to work as they are blinded. Working through all of this smoke, hoping that the wind doesn't pick up, because if the wind picks up, she's gonna be pretty much screwed from the guy with a rifle. And so we see her move quick, we see her move fast, the Bullseye taking a shot, but ends up shooting one of the clones. We see the two of them go falling from the building, and as they fall, Elektra uses this Bullseye as a cushion. Not knowing if this is actually the real Bullseye or something else, no matter what, at the end of the day, this feels good. Beating the crap out of someone that at least looks like Bullseye gives her some kind of satisfaction. But as they crash down on top of this car, she bounces off and lands on the ground, losing tons of blood, really losing any ability to be able to escape. This is when we see the Bullseye with the rifle take a shot, ricocheting the shot and hitting her in the shoulder. And now she's stuck. She doesn't know what to do. These guys are about to take her out. But this is when she pieces it together. That they are using silencers. They want to be quiet. They don't want to be heard. They don't want to get attention. And so with the bullseyes thinking they have the upper hand, thinking that they are going to take out Elektra right here and right now, we see her raise a pistol to the sky. Raising it to the sky, she completely unloads everything inside the magazine. Any kind of stealth, any kind of silence they wanted is now completely gone. And now these bullseyes are going to have to be on the run. Because every superhero in the city is looking for them. And hearing this, they are gonna come running. And with the alarm now being sound, she drops down to the ground, losing as much blood as a human being could possibly use. Before she goes into unconsciousness, she sees Iron Man and Spider-Man. They make their arrival to save the day. And the bullseyes, they are not killing her this day. Now this is where we pick up with Izzy and Butch having a conversation. Izzy kind of being the kingpin of the new Hell's Kitchen, but she is terrified. She will not leave and she thinks that Butch is on her side, but really Butch is trying to make a power play. His attempt was to kidnap her son and doing so making her step down and give up the throne so that he could be the new kingpin. But not knowing, Izzy tells him that her son has skipped town. Not in all of this commotion with all of the lockdowns, everything going on, her son decided to bail. And so Butch, getting this information, he has to formulate a new plan. He has to find a new way to convince Izzy to step down as kingpin. And on the news, they see some crazy stuff going on right now at the prison where the old Daredevil is being kept, where Matthew Murdock is being kept. And taken right outside of the prison, we are picking up with Detective Cole North. Them sitting here trying to debate what the best course of action is, but as it stands, there have been no demands. Nobody has asked for anything. And they are assuming that Daredevil is the one in charge since he is the one that made a phone call. But that phone call was very vague, telling them that they all need to stay away. And while Detective North is being filled in on all of this information, we see a car pull up. A car pull up with Daredevil's attorney, Christian McDuffie. But we see her headlights immediately shot out. Anytime anybody tries to put lights on the prison, they're immediately taken out. And as these three sit here and discuss what they're gonna do next, a uniformed officer runs up and lets them know that Daredevil is on the phone. And what Daredevil says is that he can hear the heartbeat of Cole North. He knows that he is here. And so he tells them to send in Detective North alone by himself and unarmed. Now this is where we pick up with Elektra sitting on this table being taken care of by Iron Man using his little nanobots to heal her injuries, though they're not at 100% just yet. And Elektra asks, you know, did anybody catch the bullseyes? Did anybody find them? But they scattered. Spider-Man is still searching, but they can't find them. Iron Man can't track them. And so as it stands, they still have no way of finding these bullseyes. Somehow they are working under the radar. Somebody is helping them out. You know, there may be four of them, but there's more at play here. Iron Man knows that there is something else going on. Now Elektra, she wants to get up. She wants to get up and get out there and find these bullseyes before they hurt anybody else. Iron Man telling her that she needs time. She needs time to rest and relax and let the other heroes try to find them. And this is where she tells him, like, look, like Tony Stark, I don't really know you that well, but I know enough about Tony Stark to say that the way to your heart is to ask for some upgrades. And what she is asking Tony to do is to make her a bullseye killing machine, figuratively, of course. But what she wants is some kind of suit, some kind of ability, some kind of upgrades where she can go toe to toe with four bullseyes. And so what we might see is a Daredevil Iron Man suit or an Elektra Iron Man suit. I think that would be absolutely phenomenal to see. So I'm super excited to see next issue and see what Tony Stark comes up with to help combat these bullseyes. Now this is where we pick back up at the prison, with Detective North making his way inside of the prison, going through the main doors. He has a bunch of prisoners that are escorting him through here. Now there was a time that the detective, he hunted Daredevil, even arrested him. But this was a different time. He believed in the system. He believed in the law. He fought Daredevil. And then at one point, he fought for Daredevil. He made him see that their hearts are the law. That everybody should listen to their hearts. Over anything else, always listen to your heart. And then try to make a decision from there. But right now, his heart is screaming at him. Because as it stands, it looks like Daredevil wants him dead. And as he continues being escorted through here, he comes upon a giant pile of chairs and tables, and at the top of this, sitting on the throne, it appears to be the one and only Daredevil, appearing to be king of the prison. And that will be the end of this issue. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments. This is definitely a twist I did not see coming. I didn't really know what to expect after everything transpired in the last issue, but I really didn't expect to see Daredevil sitting here playing king. And I kind of have a small feeling or indication that might not actually be Daredevil. That might be somebody else posing as Daredevil, trying to use his clout to run the prison. And like I said a little bit earlier, I am super excited to see what Iron Man comes and decides to make for Elektra. How he is going to be able to counter four of the world's best bounty hunters simultaneously. It's going to be very interesting, and I highly look forward to seeing what is on the horizon. But yeah, let me know what you guys think down in the comments. If you have not yet, do me a favor, hit that sub button, hit that notification bell, make sure you're not missing any of the awesome content we have coming out, and until the next breakdown.